here we go, the first ever regular guy in a vehicle, and it's the bike U40 Plus City Killer. So here we are in the bike B40 Plus City Killer, and first impressions of this big jeepy looking vehicle is you expect the ride to be quite hard, but everything in this vehicle has been made to luxury spec. So everything from the leather clad steering wheel to these incredibly comfortable seats that we are sitting in, it's a remarkably comfortable luxury feeling vehicle. But when you look outside through this big square windscreen, it does look like you're in an off-road vehicle. It's got the big high ride. You certainly are sitting above most of the other people on the road. You've got good view throughout the front of the vehicle, and when you do get onto the gravel and the rough stuff, it's got a really smooth ride. Very impressed with the suspension. You'll see we're going over a speed bump now. And I mean, big jump for the vehicle, but I really didn't feel it sitting here in the driving seat. So it's a very comfortable vehicle to drive. And of course, I'm driving the 2-liter turbo petrol version, which comes with a 6-speed automatic box. And it's a very, very smooth gearbox. No big jumps or jitters. It transitions between the gears really nicely. Drop the hammer, it's got some torque, as we'll see there. Very responsive. Of course, this engine coming from a Golf GTI, and you can feel a little bit of that 160 kilowatts as soon as you put your foot down on the gas. The brakes are nice and smooth, and I've got to say, the steering on this vehicle is really nice. Super responsive. You can drive with one hand, and so far, in my second day of driving it, I've got to say I'm massively impressed with this B40 Plus. We're driving around Richards Bay, a couple of potholes, a lot of speed bumps, and I'm not feeling them really, if I'm honest. It's a very comfortable drive. So we'll get it down onto some gravel now for you, and let's see how she goes when we're on the gravel. We are on the gravel now, and I drove this a little earlier in my caddy, and it was a pretty rough ride, and I had to drive really slowly. In the bike, I am doing 40 k's an hour on the gravel right now, and it's really not a bad ride at all. A couple of big bumps, you'll see me moving around, but the suspension handling really nicely. Going into a big bump now, we'll just brake for this one because it is a rather savage bump. But the vehicle handles really nicely. It's got a soft ride on the bumps. And if you're someone who's gonna be spending some time on gravel roads and on the tar, I reckon this is a very good choice for you. It's just a really nice comfy. And I mean, I said it already, these seats, wow, these seats are incredible. I feel like I'm sitting in a little leather lazy boy going over the bumps here. I mean, it is a very bumpy ride. We'll cut to some externals for you now, but no problems here inside the bike. I'm loving life. And similarly, when you're doing 4x4 in this, and of course it does have high, low, and the automatic diff, it is gonna be one of the more comfy vehicles you can drive off-road, because that ride is just so smooth. It's incredible. All right, got some pretty deep sand here I'm reversing into. Of course, it does have a diff, and you can feel the diff gripping there, but now the sand's getting pretty deep. And of course, I haven't put the tires down because I'm just on a Sunday cruise. But we just go here to the dash, boop, 4 high engaged. Oh, easy as you like, it really didn't even struggle there. And like I said, the tires are still at road pressure, so nice and easy. Slow it down, pop it back into a 2 high, and keep going with the Sunday drive, easy as you like. So we know it's comfortable, we know that it is easy to use between two-wheel and four-wheel, and most of the systems are easy to use once you figure out where all the buttons and knobs that do everything are. Now on the highway, you can see it's a pretty quiet ride, and it's one of the most impressive things about the vehicle out on the open road, because a lot of 4x, double cabs and big SUVs can have a bit of road noise. And if you've driven in a Jeep before or a Land Rover, not the quietest vehicles on the road, those off-roaders, whereas this one really nicely sealed, not getting a whole lot of wind or road noise, and drives really good on the open highway as well. Quick acceleration, and this 2-litre petrol with the turbo, very responsive when you need it. So all in all, I am massively impressed with this vehicle. You know, built by the Chinese company Bike. They are a military company. They build military spec vehicles, so I think that comes through in the build quality here, is that you can really feel that this vehicle is sturdy and solid. I think a lot of questions sometimes being asked of Chinese vehicles in that regard is that they are maybe a little bit rickety and, you know, a little bit thin on the plastics and can rattle a bit. This vehicle has none of that. It is absolutely solid, super well built. The build quality is very high. And all in all, I am massively impressed with it. It's a pleasure to drive. It certainly has the off-road capabilities. And where a lot of 4x4s maybe are a little bit toned down as far as luxury is concerned, I think this vehicle really delivers on that one. It is super luxurious inside. Of course, you can remove the roof plates as well, much like you can in the Jeep. There's also the doors are removable if you want to. Can't say that's something I would probably do. I like my doors on, but I do like that you can remove the roof, and that's something we'll try maybe in a later video. But in the meantime, as far as first impressions go, I am massively impressed with the B40 Plus. Looking forward to driving the diesel version, which comes in a manual. And of course, if you are interested in this vehicle and you would like to find out more, please do either message me on the link coming up on the top of the screen now, or you can also message me directly and I will answer any questions you have around the bike B40 Plus. This is the City Killer 2-litre turbo 6-speed auto version. And please do subscribe. Remember, those subscribed help me a hell of a lot with the videos. So if you enjoyed it, give us a like, give us a comment, and hit that subscribe button. And in the meantime, I'm going to enjoy the rest of my Sunday drive in this lovely luxury vehicle from Bike China.